एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, एंड इकोनॉमिक्स। Right? So, now we are going to study about interrelationship between anthropology and economics. So, here we also follow that approach. What is anthropology? And what is economics? Right? Then we have to write about their interrelationship means we have to learn about similarities between anthropology and economics, and that similarities on the basis of subject matter, method and application. Right? So, for the understanding of similarity between the subject matter of anthropology and economics, you can see your syllabus, topic number 3. In topic number 3, we will study economic anthropology. And in economic anthropology, we study about economic activity of mankind. In this topic, we will study about production, consumption, distribution, and exchange. Right? This subject matter already mentioned in our syllabus topic number 3. Another important topic also mentioned in that topic, impact of globalization. On indigenous economy. So first important thing, that give us insight about some interrelationship between anthropology and economics. When you are going to study second paper, there are many issues related tribal problem, economic problem of tribal people that is mentioned in second paper, like poverty, indebtedness, low literacy, health problem, nutritional problem, impact of development project on tribal, displacement, rehabilitation, tribal development program. So these important subject matter is not only subject matter of economic anthropology, but it is also a subject matter of economics. So here both have some common subject matter. Second important thing is that on the basis of method, so what is the method of economics? Which method economists utilize for the study of economics? Are you familiar? No, I am asking about how anthropologists, economists study economics. Which method economist utilize for the study of economy? Suppose any economist who want to study Indian economy, how can they study Indian economy? No, I am asking economics, not I am asking on anthropology. Here I am asking, what is the approach, which important approaches followed by economist for the study of economics? So economist followed social survey method, economic survey, a statistical method, mathematical method for the study of economics. Right? How we are doing calculation of GDP? How we calculate our national income? So we are gathering data related economics, and that data we gathered through social survey, through economic survey. So social survey and economic survey method is the core method for the study of economics. But in economic anthropology, we also utilize that. Try to understand. Suppose when you try to study about poverty, situation of poverty in Scheduled Tribe. How can we collect your data? How much people belongs from Scheduled Tribe are under poverty line? So we are going to do social survey or economic survey in tribal society. And through that, we are gathering our data. So in economic anthropology and economics, we are using social survey method or economic survey method for data gathering. And knowledge gathered by economic anthropologist and economics are utilized for the solution of economic problem of mankind. Right? It is useful for the solution of economic problem of mankind. So on the basis of that, three important aspects, we can make interrelationship between anthropology and economics, or similarity between anthropology and economics. Then we have to understand about differences. So here we can make differences between anthropology and economics on the basis of their subject matter, their method and their application. Because when you try to understand about the subject matter of anthropology, it is a holistic science. In anthropology, we study all dimensions, all aspects of mankind. While in economics, we mainly study economic aspect. Right? Economic aspect is the subject matter of economics. But when we are going to study anthropology, we will study about human biological evolution, biological variation, human ecology, human environment, history, society, political system, economic activity, human behavior, human psychology, culture and personality. These are the subject matter of anthropology. Right? So first, you make differences between anthropology and economics. In anthropology is the holistic study of mankind, economics is the study of human activity. Second, the scope of anthropology is wider, the scope of economics is narrower. Third, anthropologists interested to study about primitive economy, right? Primitive economy, because anthropologists mainly interested to study about economy of tribal people, economy of simple society, economy of rural society, while economists mainly interested to study about economic activity of modern industrial society. Here, they study economic activity of mankind according to socio-cultural perspective. We try to understand economic activity of simple people, primitive people, according to their culture, because their economic activity is deeply interlinked with their culture. Right? As for example, when Maler Pahariya go to do shifting cultivation, they worship their Goshain before going to do shifting cultivation. They worship their Goshain after cultivation. But in economy, modern economic system, our economy is not deeply interrelated with our culture. We do our economic activity for the fulfillment of economic need, not for the fulfillment of social or cultural need. So here, that is different. Next, in anthropology, participant observation. Always remember that participant observation is main method. While in economics is based on mainly a statistical method, mainly mathematical method, and application knowledge and data gathered by anthropologists have more application than economics. So on the basis of that, you can make differences between anthropology and economics. And lastly, you can write your conclusion. There are fundamental differences between anthropology and economics. But about that differences, both disciplines are deeply interrelated with each other because both are complementary to each other. Right? More useful economic anthropology. Because in economic anthropology, we study primitive economy as well as modern economy. But in economics, we only study modern economy. So recently, the scope of economic anthropology is also become very wider, because now economic anthropologists are interested to study about primitive economy as well as modern economy.
Primitive economy